वेलकम वन एंड ऑल. वंस अगेन वी हैव सर विलियम सर विद अस. विलियम सर टुडे इज गोइंग टू टेक अ शॉर्ट इनटू अस इनटू अ शॉर्ट जर्नी. यू कैन से अ ट्रेलर ऑफ व्हाट विल बी डन इन इज रेमेडियल मेजर्स, अ कंपेंडियम ऑफ रेमेडियल मेजर्स. सर प्लीज इन शॉर्ट, बिकॉज देर आर मेनी मेनी क्वेरीज कमिंग टू अस कि एग्जैक्टली वॉट विल बी टेकन, वेदर the it will be taken with examples and everything, nakshatra remedies will be given or not. Please if you can just give us the information, people can just go and visit this video and find out the topics.
Yes ma'am, this is a compendium of remedial measures. This is my 35 years experience. I'm only prescribing remedial measures which I used and which I've seen as effective. Some are very few, which is not found in books. It's just my personal research. I've about 39 topics I'm covering in these 2 days session. I will just tell you the contents of what will be there and certain highlights on the most important things. Okay. See, the first principle must be Dhatu Moola Jeeva Rasis. You need to know first to have a remedy. We'll be discussing about this in detail. Then elemental science. The fiery, earthy, airy, watery signs and how they will be helpful for remedy. Bhava and remedies, planets and remedies, Bhava, planets and remedies. How to combine all three to get to a remedy. This we'll be discussing in detail. Then for everybody to find the Ishta Devata, Parigara Devata and the remedies, the general rules to identify the Ishta Devata. This we'll be discussing in two ways. One we'll be discussing the D1 chat. And one we'll be discussing also using the Vimsamsa chart. Okay. We'll do in detail. Then the planetary conjunction in Devata schemes. A single planet, we will know the Devata. But if there's a multiple of planets, what will be the Devata? How will the Devata change? Will the general Devata scheme stand when a planet is in a masculine sign or a feminine sign? These details we'll be discussing. Then the planets, it's Adi Devata and Pratyadi Devata, the tutelary rod. And the overlord as per Bodhayana Maharishi. We will be discussing, right? Then the Badagasthana and the various doshas, sabs, curses, their general rules, when to apply them, and if applicable, what are the remedial measures we'll be discussing. These are the first day contents. The first day contents continues up to 23. Then another very interesting is, just not been in any book also, in how to use the Ashtavarga and use the remedies, the lowest and the highest points, and how to find out. This will be a very interesting session on Ashtavarga and remedies. Then another first time we'll be discussing, which is not in any books, is among the Shodasa Vargas, Sapta Varga Devatas alone can be used for worship. Others, vargas are not for worship, they are only for predictive techniques. Yeah, this, especially Dwadasamsa, Shodasamsa, Siddhamsa, Nakshantramsa, Trimshamsa, Vimsamsa, these devatas, there is a method and technique how to use them. We'll be discussing this in detail. And especially Vimsamsa deals with the Dasamaha Vidya, which is divided into 40 devis, 40. What is it, how to use them, for what purpose to use them. Apart from the general D1 devatas, how do you use these seven saptavargas to identify the deity and how to please them, get over the problems. We'll be discussing this in detail. Then we have a lamp remedy. How many faces, which face it is to be done, what kind of oil to be added. What is it, especially in fiery science, lamp remedy is an excellent remedy. Right. We'll be discussing lamp remedy. Medicinal baths, watery signs become a dustana, medicinal bath will be the best. So what are the medicines, what kind of bath we take will be benefited, we'll be discussing. Donation related planets, certain things, sometimes when the 12th house is, or the second house is involved, earthy signs involved, donation is very, very important. So what donation we do to the planets, we'll be discussing. The wearing of roots, Moola Rasi signs, wearing roots will be the most important thing. So we'll be discussing what kind of roots will assuage which planet. Similar is trees and shrubs, growing trees and shrubs, watering trees and shrubs, praying to shrubs, circumambulating trees and shrubs are a part of a temple ritual. We'll be discussing for each nakshatra, and planet, which are the trees and shrubs which should be used. These are the first day 23 first day contents. We'll move to the most important contents. The second day will be going on astro vastu remedies. This will be a very, very interesting session, because this is not the general vastu. We'll be superimposing the horoscope on the house or the company or the office. Like any remedy without the vastu correction, it can go waste. Like example, if I can tell you, somebody has Saturn Rahu, Saturn Mars in a particular sign, and that is the bedroom or the entrance, no remedy will correct it. This has to be corrected. So this will show you. I'll give an example to show what are the 12 zodiac and what are their directions and how to apply them. This will be very, very interesting. I think this is my highlight of this particular remedial measures, because I've seen every homa done, every temple visit done, every mantra done. But if the vastu is wrong, and this all snapshot prediction, just changing the mirror, changing a photo kept in the wrong side, or a window kept closed or open, activates many things. So from quick to very effective remedies, we'll discuss in the astro vastu remedies. Gemstone is remedial measures. The aura of the person, the chakra of the person, the planetary of the person can be activated with gemstone. We'll be discussing in detail for each lagna, moon, and with varga chart for which person, which stone has to be chosen. Color therapy. This is a very therapeutic tool. How colors, how it's consumed, used, kept around us, can alter and activate the planets. We're discussing this. Then mantras will be, and planetary remedies will be using the mantras which I have used and has been very effective, and the other stotras and other related planetary and the Adhidevata Pratyadevata mantras will be discussing in detail. Bachelor remedies. See, this is many people think this is only for psychological uses, but no. Like example, there are two malefics in second house, it blocks finance. Two malefic in seventh, it is marital problems. Two malefic planets in the fifth house, it is progeny related problems. Or sixth, eighth, and lagna is afflicted, you have health problems. If the psychological problems can be removed by just using a batch flower therapy. We'll be discussing in detail how batch flower therapy can be act as a planetary remedy.
Right.
How to remove a financial block or a delayed marriage can be just be remedied by having a batch flower therapy.
Acha.
Psychological remedies is not only psychological problems. It can affect every part of our life.
Right. Financial remedy, like financial blocks also can be removed, yes, by such simple...
See, half the problem is it's our belief system, and what we have programmed it is. How do we deprogram a particular belief into what is my value of money will matter a lot. How much do I attract money into my life? This can be easily seen with Saturn Ketu. You know, limiting beliefs will be the reason why a person is not getting enough money. To expand his consciousness, his awareness, create a more space into his heart to receive money. So the best, easiest remedy is batch flower. I've seen it working wonders.
Acha. Okay.
The numerology and remedial measures. I'll be using the method which I effectively use. I've seen when anybody has number 8, I've seen their lives going bad, very bad. Certain numbers can wreck their life. In that case, numerology should be the only remedy. Like certain things where vastu is a remedy, in certain things, numerology should be the best remedy. Then we have Lal Kitab remedies. This is a very cost-effective tantric remedy, very simple remedy. I'll be explaining all the 9 planets in 12 houses and what they affect and what is the remedy. I've seen it working instant remedies, which will work in give instant results. We'll be having a discussion on the Lal Kitab and remedies. Then we come to activation of planets and houses. How do we, it is not necessary a planet in transit or in chart or Dasabhukti must happen to activate a planet. Just by doing a particular activity, we can activate a planet. Example, going to a temple, activates the 9th house. Just the 9th house is not activated. The fortune, prosperity, the bhakya, the Pitru, everything's activated. So each particular house, how do we activate or deactivate it just by doing a particular activity? So we'll be nine planets into 12 houses, about 144 combinations. We'll be discussing how to activate. A very interesting session will be there. Then I'll be mentioning certain most important temples of India for certain dosh. Apart, I've already mentioned the mantras and the parigaras I've mentioned. I'll be mentioning Kalatra dosha and temples. Delayed marriage, bad marriage, problematic marriage, those kind, which temples one should go to be remedied. I've mentioned about each and 15 temples I've mentioned. Then we have Putra dosha and temples, delayed child or a problematic children, health problems for children. All this Putra dosha temples one can go. Then Pitru dosha. Pitru dosha is a very big problem. The ninth house is afflicted. I have about 15 temples. I have the best temple, most effective temples in my experience. We'll be discussing about that. Then Sarpa dosha temples. Certain I've mentioned with puja, what can be remedied. With mantras, what can be remedied. There are certain, sometimes it we have to use. We have to go to the temple to visit. So I've mentioned about 15 most important temples of India, which is necessary to remove Sarpa dosha. For longevity issues, or health related issues, I've written about 10 and more remedial measures. Then Navagraha doshas, which are the main temples which has to be visited in Navagraha, so I'll be mentioning. So I'll be taking practical cases. If you want, we can even take live cases, and we'll be discussing after the session, 2-day session, how anybody can use this. And this is a compendium. Once you know this, anybody can, what I say, be a master of doing the remedy. Maybe a follow-up and practice within a month. You will know which are the mantras, what are the techniques. You will know the principles, everything around using remedial measures.
Sir, yes. And you also said ki even the newcomers and the beginners can also join, because in this I see 75% remedies are such that they can easily follow.
Yeah, it is. I'm not using too detailed, except for the Varga charts. Even that is very simple. I'm just telling how to use the Varga. There's not any predictive techniques are there. You just look at the even software, you will know what you can use it. I think you just need to know 9 planets, 12 bhavas, or the meaning of the bhavas. That is enough to use this remedial measures.
So this, I think you have correctly named it, compendium of remedial measures. It's a vast subject, and thank you very much for taking this subject with us. So I hope people can just go through this video and all their questions are answered and they come in to join the session. Thank you very much.
Sure, ma'am.